Hello Internet, I'm Hazel, and this is a quick guide showing you how to defeat Tarr the Terrible using two pets for the Awfully Big Adventure achievement, or just to power level a pet. For my first pet, I'm going to use my Scooter the Snail. Any snail will do fine, grab the one with the highest attack stat out of your available snails. In the second slot, I've got Mr. Grubbs. You could also use a Maggot, a Festering Maggot, a Devouring Maggot, a Larva, or a Jungle Grubb. If you're excited about the whole maggot thing, you can even forget the snail and just have two grubs. Set his moves to consume and leap. For my carry pet, today I'm bringing my molten corgi. If you're after an awfully big adventure, just bring along your Elekk Plushie, stick him in the back, and don't worry about switching him in. If you're leveling a pet, make sure it has at least 900 health or more, and don't forget your safari hat. Alright, so make sure that your leveling pet is on top if you are in fact planning to level a pet. And he starts with Gladiator Merkelot, so our goal here, to start with, is of course just to get one round of attack off, and then switch out. This is why you want to have a good amount of health. That first move that Merkelot does hurts quite a lot, so it's best to have a somewhat higher level pet to be leveling. Now, against Deathy, we bring out our Snail. Of course, start with the Snail if you are just using your Elekk Plushie in the back, and then we're going to want to get our Shell Shield up immediately to negate the extra damage that Scorched Earth would be burning us for. So, with Snail versus Deathy, you want to keep up Shell Shield and then spam Absorb. Absorb is going to do strong damage against him, it is going to heal you up for a good amount. And the other benefit of being a snail in this situation is that if anybody tries to stun you, it's not going to work because you just can't stun snails. They're critters, it just don't work. So, there we are. We are blocking the extra fire damage and he's chipping away at us. Ideally, if I was faster than him, I would be able to dive to avoid this charging and then big bursts of damage, but you know, we're not faster than them, we're a snail. Snails are slow. So, moving on. Fairly simple, keep it up. You are healing for quite a bit, which lets you outlast at least the first pet, usually pet and a half on the snail, and it helps that they tend to have rather high health pools to begin with. So, almost done. Down goes Deathy. Now, he does like to switch around his pets a lot, so you need to be prepared to adapt your strategy. Generally, you don't want to switch unless you have to. So, versus Merkelot, we're doing pretty much the same thing. We're going to forget about the Shell Shield now because, or at least once the Scorched Earth falls off, which it's going to, because that's no longer going to be a problem. It won't necessarily mitigate enough damage to make it worth the turn when we could have been healing for 200 to begin with. So, keep damaging him. And we're actually faster than Merkimus, which is quite nice. You can block it, but that's alright. Just keep it up with absorb spamming. That's basically it. The nice thing about this fight is that it is a little bit brain dead. You gotta pay a little bit of attention, and this pet battle info add-on that I'm using to view the cooldowns in the tooltip of the enemy pet here is nice. There you go, so he's up heroic leaping. This is the point where you want to dive. We're faster than this guy, so we can get out of the way of that. And that's gonna save you a good chunk of damage and get you some extra momentum to damage Merkimus with. So there we go. Snail finally goes down and it is time for the grub. Now, whether you're using one grub or two grubs, your strategy with the grub is to leap and then consume and then leap and then consume and then repeat that forever. Leap is going to keep your damage, or rather your speed. Leap is going to keep your speed much higher than any of the enemy pets. Consume is going to keep your health pretty high. Consume is going to damage him quite strongly. And then we're just filling in with leap basically because consume has a one round cooldown. Because we are a beast-type pet, both Merkimus and this last guy are going to do reduced damage against us, even with their big bursty abilities, so there's nothing to really worry about, and the guy that was stun-happy seems to be dead at this point, so we're in good shape. And there we are. You can get away with, I've heard people getting away with two snails, I've heard of people getting away with two grubs, I've heard of some crazy undead pet combinations for this kind of thing, but you know, I like the one snail and one grub, it's balanced, it works good. Dog consume, and then leap, and then consume, and then leap, and yeah, keep that up. We're gonna skip ahead in time a little bit, because we're just consuming and leaping here. And down he goes with lots of health to spare, no problems. It would take some really bad RNG to mess this up for you. And that's how I do it. Check out my channel for other pet battle videos, vlogs, and stuff like that. Thanks for watching, and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye!